Yes, you've got to get over a bit of the stigma of, oh, it's drugs. But any rational, educated, intelligent person, once you sit down and explain it to them, they're quite open-minded and interested, so. I lost the father of my younger two daughters when they were 3 and 5, 6 years ago. And 6 weeks before I lost my partner, my dad died unexpectedly. So I lost the two most important men in my life at that time. Then I got into a relationship with a man in the States, and I moved over there, and I divorced and moved back here. Yes, I was a single parent, single mum for the first time, and I came back with nothing, so I was still grieving. I'd been through that the relationship in America had been quite a very difficult, challenging one, and so yeah, I was sort of processing a lot, still grieving, moving back here to a city I didn't want to be in with 2 young children, no money, no car, nowhere to live, no career, and at the same time I hit perimenopause, which doesn't really get discussed very much. So my hormones were all over the place. I was, really struggling on multiple levels, and so that's when I started microdosing. And then I decided to go to the mushrooms because, again, I use different strains of mushrooms already. So I was just like, yeah, I think I want to take something natural because I already sort of have that trust in that aspect. As I said, I was in a really, really dark place when I came back, like at a time when I was supposed to be, getting my life together and being a single mum and getting myself back on my feet with 2 young children. So there was a real clash there, and I felt a lot of despair. I was crying a lot. I didn't want to get out of bed. So when I took the microdoses, I found that it helped me feel like my old self, like the part of me, the old me that I knew that, could take on the world, sort of, knew how to take on challenges. And as a therapist too, like for someone who's been helping people for almost 2 decades and, does a lot of my own processing and has a lot of, skills and strength, it was really hard to feel like I didn't have even my own internal support the way I used to. So I felt when I took the microdoses, it's just like, oh, I'm me again. And it was just a reminder that I would get through this really, really hard period. It was still hard. It didn't stop being hard and challenging, but it just helped me get through it as, with some of my old sense of spark and strength and trust in life and, friends and family as well. Like, just, remembering that I had resources all around me and knowing how to access them. Almost 4 years ago, I read a book called A Really Good Day by Arlette Wildman. And yeah, so that sort of really set me off on the path of exploring it more. And yeah, I just did as much research as I could on the internet. For me personally, I'm not someone who would take antidepressants or pharmaceuticals. So for me, it was getting my head around that I'm taking something that could alter my mental state. I took other mushrooms for health reasons, so I was like, this is just another health, benefit, and it's just working on a different level of, my mind and my emotions. So it's, 3.5 years on, and I feel it's been a really hard journey. But yeah, it's, it would have been hard no matter what. That's life sometimes. Life throws everything at you, and I sort of had a lot to deal with. I think what it gave me most of all was some emotional stability, which was really helpful, but also clarity of mind. So I was able then again to use the clarity of my thinking to find the resources that I needed, and to make better decisions rather than sort of just, feeling like I was drowning. So anything can be abused. I mean, any system, doesn't matter how regulated it is. Pharmaceuticals can be abused. You've got good doctors and bad doctors, great psychologists, bad psychologists. And again, this is where I think we need to be, Australia needs to be smart and thinking about the systems that they're implementing. How is it going to be implemented? How is it going to be dispensed? Like, I think there's a call for it, there's a need for it, and people, want to take something that's more natural and more in symbiotic with our own, human body and our systems and has less side effects. But yeah, there's always going to be people also that have negative effects, that it's not the right thing for them, and that's why I say it should be done with integration, with support, with a psychologist, therapist, psychiatrist.
you know, they may well do. People may well have had benefits, and who knows how they're taking it and what they attribute as benefits, and it'd be interesting to follow them up over time, because sometimes in the short term they may feel benefits, and what they see as benefits isn't necessary. You know, I'll have patients who think they're doing great, meanwhile their, you know, marriage is falling apart, can't hold down their job, but you know, emotionally they feel high or elevated. So really it's very hard to make any meaningful comment. Now again, it has different meanings, microdosing. Certainly from a purely clinical point of view, there's no evidence that microdosing is somehow potentially therapeutic for diagnosable mental illness. And the several patients I've seen over the years who, you know, what might be called microdosing, often when I just give them just legitimate kind of mainstream treatments, they improve and they don't need to microdose. So I certainly don't encourage people. I can see the attraction of microdosing, and it has a certain glamour about it, and it has been glamorized in entertainment media sometimes, and especially there's an association with being more creative, being more kind of, what's the word, you know, being more sort of free and energized, but it's certainly not something that I, as a serious clinical psychiatrist, can recommend, and I'd encourage people to seek alternative mainstream treatments. So I think it's one of those things where people probably want to just take it recreationally, and this is a convenient way to potentially justify that. But in reality, it often worsens people. If you already have some vulnerabilities towards mental health problems, it more often than not, it potentially worsens it. And that's where it's, you know, not to be recommended.